Hello everyone, welcome to Edit Up. So in today's session, we are going to discuss a very important finance news article regarding the RBI that has launched the Innovation Hub. So we are going to discuss all about the Innovation Hub, that why it has been launched by RBI and where it has been launched and inaugurated, as well as the initial capital contribution for the Innovation Hub. So this news article is very important and you have to remember the facts in this news article, okay? So now before starting with the session, please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you are new to the channel and join our Telegram channel for the PDF of this session. And you can get the link of the Telegram channel in the description box below. So now starting with the first news article, this news article, that is the RBI has inaugurated the RBIH. So this RBIH is Reserve Bank Innovation Hub. Okay, so this is the full form of RBIH, Reserve Bank Innovation Hub. So the RBI Governor Shaktikanta Das has inaugurated the RBIH in Bangalore. So it has been launched or it has been inaugurated in Bangalore by the RBI Governor. And about the hub now, that the hub has an independent board with Gopalakrishnan as the chairman. So it has the independent board where there will be many members from academia, from different industries, from different sectors, and the chairman is Gopalakrishnan. The central bank has said this in a statement. So the RBI has set up the RBIH as a Section 8 of company under the Companies Act of 2013 with an initial capital contribution of ₹100 crore. So try to remember this. So now the objective behind establishment of RBIH, that why RBI has taken the step of establishing RBIH. So this is to encourage and nurture the world-class financial innovation. Okay, so remember the keywords, financial innovation. RBI wants the financial innovation in the financial sector in the country in a sustainable manner, in a continuous manner. It's not like we want to bring in new technology to get today and we want to stop now. No, in a sustainable manner, in a continuous manner, we want to do the financial innovation for the development of the financial sector. And when the financial sector develops, the country will also develop. So through an institutional setup, okay, so that's why a separate independent board has been made for the RBIH, and this has been set up so that we have a proper institutional setup that can promote the financial innovation, that can promote the technological advancement. Coupled with the underlying theme of financial inclusion, whenever the financial sector is developing, whenever the financial innovations are coming into the country, that means the financial inclusion will also further. Okay, so the RBIH, now this we have understood that why RBI has set it up. Now why is the major aim of the RBIH? So the RBIH aims to create an ecosystem that focuses on promoting the access of the financial services and products. So the RBIH aim is to provide the access, to provide the services and the products of the financial sector to the low income households, so also to provide it to the low income population in the country also. So the services and the products of the financial sector should reach to each and everyone. That is what we call the financial inclusion, na? So the financial promotion is there, that as well as financial access is there, as well as financial inclusion is there. Okay, the hub would bring convergence among various stakeholders. So different, as I have said, that the academia members are there, the industry, different industry members are there, different sectors are involved. So this will, the hub will bring the convergence of various stakeholders, where BFSI means banking, financial service, insurance sector, the startup ecosystem, the regulators and the academia will come together, will be converging in this hub in the financial innovation space. Okay, the hub will collaborate with financial sector institutions, technology industry and academic institutions and coordinate efforts for exchange of ideas. So the ideas will be exchanged, the development will be promoted of prototypes related to financial innovation. So the financial innovation can come through the financial products, through the financial services. It would develop internal infrastructure to promote the fintech research. Okay, so all of the big minds will come together, all of the big members, all of the academia, the different industry, the fintech, the financial segments, the institutions, the banking sector, the financial service sector, all of them will come together for the fintech research and facilitate engagement with innovators and startups. Even the new startups will be brought up, will be promoted through this hub, so that the technological innovation, so that the financial innovation can come into the financial segment. Okay, so this is the logo of the RBIH, the Reserve Bank Innovation Hub. This is the motto. We can say that your innovation is our mission. Your innovation, our mission. We aim to encourage. So RBIH has said that we aim to encourage and accelerate financial sector innovation for fostering partnerships, by fostering partnerships. So the aim is for the financial inclusion, financial innovation in the financial sector, in the finance sector, by fostering, by establishing partnerships between the different segments. We all are, the big sectors are doing the financial innovations, but they are doing it separately. So now the this RBIH wants all of the sectors to come together. So this is the motto, innovation. Okay, enabling innovation environment by leveraging technology to enhance the capabilities of the Indian financial system. Then inclusion should be there, that all of the people, the billions of Indians, should come together and have the access to frictionless financial services. They should have the access of the financial services. Impact should be there. When the inclusion is there, when they are using the products, when they are using the services, there should be some impact in their lives also. So to create economic opportunities for every Indian, for the startups, there would be an opportunity when they will be using the products and the services. They will know more about the financial system. That will create the awareness, that will create the knowledge, that will create the skills also, because we will be very intrigued to work in that segment maybe. So economic opportunities for every Indian through the innovation and inclusion will also be provided. This is the motto of the RBIH. So RBIH has also brought the Swarnari program. This is the RBIH Swarnari program. Swarnari means Swanirbhar. Swanirbhar Nari, that is self-reliant lady. Okay, so woman from a disproportionately large share of the world's unbanked and undeserved population. So women are the one that are in the unbanked area, that do not have the banking services that is provided to them. They are the deserving candidates that is not provided the proper system, we can say financial system. With nearly billion women without access to financial service products. So they are not provided, they are unbanked. They are unbanked. That is, they are not being provided with the banking services, with the financial services products. So RBIH has the Swarnari program now. Okay, so try to remember all of the facts that you have accumulated today. Okay, and this is the question that will bolster that you have remembered the facts or not. Okay, so recently, March 2022, RBI Governor Shaktikanta Das has inaugurated the Reserve Bank Innovation Hub. Which of the following statements is correct regarding the RBIH? Okay, remember the three I's also. Innovation, inclusion and impact. That question can be formed from there also. So this is the question. I hope you can easily answer this question now. So thank you very much. I hope you have understood the today's news article. If there is any query, you can mail us here or you can contact us through this number. Thank you very much.